Welcome back as we broadcast live from the Yabun Festival, celebrating the survival of Aboriginal people and cultures. It's been a busy day of music, dance, ideas and sport here. And earlier this afternoon, I spoke to Aunty Cathy Craigie from Gadigal Information Service.
Social revolution is coming.
Aunty Cathy Craigie, firstly, happy Survival Day to you.
Thank you, Natalie. What a great day, though. Even though it's raining, the crowds have turned up, Yabun's still happening, and, you know, we've got lots of people smiling, all about mob coming together, seeing your relatives you haven't seen for ages, you know. Rain, hail or snow, we're all out here, aren't we?
Well, you've mentioned the drizzle. Hasn't kept people away, though. How many do you reckon you've got down here today?
We roughly, every other year, we're roughly about 10, 15 to 20,000 people. I'd say we've got a rough 10,000 here today. I mean, I think people have made an attempt to come out and, you know, it's all about, I think it's about all being together. And that's what our mob really enjoy this day about, is getting out and seeing everybody, just spending time with your own mob and, you know, feeling comfortable about being in a place that's ours for at least one day.
It is something of an uncomfortable day, January 26th, isn't it? But Yabun sort of seeks to kind of turn that on its ear a little bit, doesn't it?
Yeah, look, you know, I was reading an interesting blog this week, an Aboriginal woman that was saying, you know, why are we changing it from Invasion Day to Survival, and that aren't we watering it down? But I think, you know, there's a lot of change in people's thinking. It's about being positive about who we are and being proud of who we are and not feeling like we're being pushed back all the time and having to fight. And for me, it is about, you know, the fact that we have survived 200 or so more years of colonisation and that we're still here. We're multiplying. In fact, we're the fastest growing population in Australia. And, you know, we're still really proud to be who we are and identify as being Aboriginal.
Certainly been a great day, and thank you so much for having NITV News along, and thank you for sparing time in your very busy day to talk to us.
No, thanks, Natalie, and happy, happy Survival Day. We know it's Invasion Day, but it's, you know, we've survived.
Well, the Speak Out tent has been one of the focal points at this year's Yabun Festival once again. The head of the Prime Minister's Advisory Council, Warren Mundine, was in the thick of it with an interesting proposal about treaty and his thoughts on what the day represents.
Well, it comes out of the, you know, the Arthur Phillip and his arrival in Sydney Cove, Warran, as we call it in Aboriginal languages, is that, and so it's the invasion. It is the day of mourning for us, but in recent times it's become a day of celebration in survival, the survival day, and saying here we are here. So it is a conflict, internal conflict, in regard to sadness, grief, but celebration and survival. If we are going to really celebrate Australian Day, there are problems in that Australia was founded on the 1st of January 1901, that's New Year's Day. That's a problem to have it on that day. So there is definitely a day that we need to find. You know, I made a suggestion today in regard looking at the treaty process that we could look at signing off of the treaties that on this date, which should have been done in 1788, which was done in other countries, Canada, United States, New Zealand and that. Then it could be a celebration then of truly of Australia becoming as a united nation. You know, we are a great country. I'm a very proud Australian, as much as I'm a proud and a Bundjalung person. But it is a conflict day. Australia is more than 225 years old. It's thousands of years old. We need to share our culture. We need to share our history. We need to be frank about it, and we need to move forward as a community.
Well, as we heard Aunty Cathy Craigie tell us just a few moments ago, Yabun is one of Australia's largest Indigenous cultural events, attracting thousands of people each year from right across New South Wales. A little earlier, NITV News caught up with some of this year's festival goers to ask what this day and this event means to them.
Survival Day is a good day for everybody to get together and celebrate our culture and mingle in the mob.
You know, it doesn't matter what day it is, it might be for the non-Indigenous people, it could be an Australian Day, but it's a reminder for us too of what happened back then, you know, and it's a celebration for us. We're still alive.
Well, they can go and have their Barbie. I don't think there'll be many Barbies today, but they can go, you know, do their own thing. But in their minds, and this is hard for a lot of Australian people, is you've got to remember that you're on stolen land. You've got to remember that the only reason you are in the situation you are is because you're on stolen land.
Today means to me an important day for us to recognise, respect and to remember those lives that were lost, that were massacred when the so-called colonisers came to this country. A day like this for me is good to share with the first Australians, with the original people.
Just gives me the opportunity to stand proud and be proud of who I am, be proud of my family, be proud of where I come from. It's also a chance to get out and let the wider community know that we're still alive and that we're doing great as and our culture is still alive.
Just here keeping it strong with the boys and girls here, the Aboriginal people of our country, keeping it alive, keeping it strong. And we can see by the turnout today and all the turnouts around Australia, we're really keeping it alive and keeping our culture at the foremost.